Hey guys,
my name is Kuyanche, and welcome to episode 3 of my Applied Energistics 2 tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So last episode, we talked about the very basics of Applied Energistics Network, and how you're able to combine separate ME chests into one network. But today, we are going to take it one step further, because, as I already explained, on a non-ME controller network, so a very basic Applied Energistics 2 network, you are only able to connect 8 devices at a time. But, of course, if you want a big system, that's not so much. So, it's time to change it up with a very big step, which is the ME controller. The ME controller pretty much acts like the heart of an Applied Energistics 2 system. Recipe shown right now, by the way. As you can see, this is how it looks. Pretty much this is it being turned off, this is it having power, and this is when you connect multiple pieces together. So they look pretty cool. And pretty much this is the center of your new Applied Energistics 2 network. What the benefits of using an ME controller is, I will be talking about that in just a minute. But first I will be explaining a little bit of the rules of how this works. So, ME controllers can only be placed up to 7 in a row in a single structure. So pretty much the biggest size you can get on a Applied Energistics ME controller setup is a 7x7x7 and in between that. Because if I were to, for example, add an 8th piece, so as you can see right now it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If I would add an 8th piece to this, you would see the system crashes. Pretty much indicating with a bright red color. But also if I would add any other mutation in between, this is still valid apparently. But if I would do something like there, it doesn't work. But I am able to go through the inside to make a square, for example. So that is definitely something you want to keep in mind. So now, why would you use an ME controller instead of just a normal network? That's because an ME controller is able to connect 32 channels on each side that you are able to access on the ME controller. So that is already quite a big upgrade compared to the 8 that you can only connect on just a basic network. But then you might be asking, like, we talked about those basic cables before, basic ME glass cables and ME smart cables, but they were only able to transfer 8 cables at once, and you said that these are able to transfer 32 at once. How does that work, Gorge? Well, yeah, that's where a little bit of a different cable comes in. So, I made a little bit of a demonstration setup right here, just to show you guys. But for this purpose, we'll be using ME dense cabling. ME dense cabling is pretty much an upgrade of ME gloss cabling, or ME smart cabling, which is able to transfer 32 channels through one cable. It has its downsides, but also a lot of upsides. Because, as you can see right here, in this little demonstration, what I have done is, again, an ME controller and a creative energy cell to power this. And to that, I got myself one ME dense cable line hooked up. Connected, or pretty much branched off from that, is a set of ME smart cables, which I dyed red and blue just to, you know, make it a little bit clear to you guys to see. You can pretty much dye ME color, ME cables and pretty much all cables in Applied Energistics 2 with all the 16 colors in Minecraft, so that's pretty cool. And they will have a little bit of a special features when you use multiple colors, but I will, you know, talk about that in a later episode. No need to really talk about that yet. So, the cool thing is, of course, that you are able to make use of an ME controller that is able to transmit 32 channels on each side. There is only one downside, is that not all devices can connect to ME dense cabling. For example, terminals won't connect to ME dense cabling, but only ME smart cables. Honestly, that's not so big of a deal, because you mostly want to use ME smart cablings or ME glass cablings whenever you can, because they are a lot cheaper than ME dense cabling, and, you know, there's no real big use for them in most normal cases. So as you can see right there, I got myself 4 separate lines of 8 machines, just 8 ME chests, for demonstration purpose, of course. Each one, of course, filling 8 channels. As you can see on the ME smart cables right here, you can see the amount of channels that are being added. All the way up to 8 devices on this line. And then they're being merged together into this one ME dense cabling. And the same with all these other separate lines. So right here, as you can see, I only got 8 channels. So up to this point, it only has 8 channels going through this cable line. As also indicated on the ME dense cable lines right here. Each line is 4 devices, so pretty cool. Then as you can see right here, the other lines get added, so that adds 18 more. And as you can see on Wayla, on the top of the screen, you can also see it has 16 out of 32 channels connected. Then right here, the other 8 get added, which is 24. And then right here is the 32 channels, which completely maxes out the ME controller. So, of course, you might be wondering, okay, what would happen if I add one more device? Well, that is a pretty good question. Like I demonstrated right there, what would happen is that either something will disconnect, so one of these devices won't be able to actually get power anymore, or it will simply crash. It really depends on where you decide to actually hook up the device. I'm fairly certain if I put it right there, something here should be disconnected now. It's sort of a little bit difficult to troubleshoot sometime, but just keep in mind that trying to add more than 32 channels on this ME controller will disconnect one of the devices. So that is kind of annoying. So, of course, I only used one of these sides right there, and you might think like, okay, but we have 6 more sides to only a single block, and, you know, if you want to make big multi-blocks, you can even make something like this to store a lot of channels. Trust me, that's a lot. That's where I made this little demonstration setup. This is the most optimum solution what you can do for a single ME controller. As you can see, I got myself this ME controller in the center. And ME dense cabling coming out of all sides of this ME controller. The cool thing is that using an ME controller, you can also just hook up something like an energy cell directly to any cabling instead of having to directly power the ME controller, which will work just fine. So that saves you, you know, a side of this controller. Then what I did is I pretty much moved all the dense cabling so they are in a line next to each other. Pretty cool. Meaning that I now have 192 channels available, meaning I am able to connect 192 pretty much whatever you want. Terminals, for example, a crafting terminal, which is a pretty cool device, pretty much an upgrade of the regular terminal, but with a crafting grid in it, which is pretty awesome. But of course also ME drive, normal terminals, what other things did I talk about? Import buses, export buses, interfaces, all that kind of cool stuff. 192 times. And of course, this is one big network, so everything on these lines connect. So pretty much each of these cables indicates a machine that you're able to use. So 8 times 4 times, in this case, 6 equals, you know, 192. So, for example, I got myself a ME drive right here on this side with a 4K storage cell in it. And on a different line right here, I hooked up the terminal that is able to access the ME drive content. You know, I'm able to actually take the items out of the drive and put it back in, of course. And the same with any other terminals or devices hooked up on this network. It's just one big device, which is able to interact with all other things together. Pretty awesome. That's what I thought. So yes, this is pretty much the key feature of bigger ME networks. If you let your imagination flow, you can pretty much imagine, like, if I would build a 7x7 cube and try to hook up a bunch of dense cabling next to each other, you are very easily able to get over 1,000 channels in one network, if not more. I once, in a demonstration world, made a system that is able to transfer over 9,000 channels. And that's not just the over 9,000 joke. No, but it's like actually over 9,000 channels in one ME network. Which is, you know, crazy. If you ever decide to build some massive factory in your world, that's, you know, that's something pretty cool. Like in the center of your world, floating something, massive cube of doom. Cool stuff. So yes, guys, that is pretty much the gist of ME networking. Of course, in the next episodes, I will get more in depth with what you can do with the networks and what you're able to connect to them. Of course, I will also be talking about things like auto crafting soon. Better storage methods, sorting, processing, yeah, just a lot of stuff. Also, of course, integration with other mods, automation with things that you wouldn't normally expect to be able to automate normally. So yeah, that's pretty awesome. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you found it educational. And like always, feel free to let me know down in the comment section or on the forum in the description if you have any feedback. And I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.